Hello everyone from Motion VFX and welcome to this new tutorial on M-Channel Clean for DaVinci Resolve. M-Channel Clean is one of our best-selling packs from Final Cut Pro and it is now available for DaVinci Resolve. In this tutorial, we will see how to create from this basic editing a nice and dynamic opener for a fake fashion channel. Of course, you can apply all this effect to any topics. Before starting, let's see the final result. M-Channel Clean is optimized for the edit page. To access to all the content from M-Channel Clean, open the FX library. Inside the toolbox, the content is split in three categories: video transitions, titles, and FX. Concerning the workflow with the FX, DaVinci Resolve doesn't manage very well the timing of the fusions effects and it can cut animations. So the workaround to avoid this problem is to use adjustment clip with the FX. And as I will use adjustment clips a lot, I will add it to the favorite section by clicking on the star. A second tip concerning the workflow, as the content is split in three categories, you can click on the Toolbox Master folder and in the search field, type M-Channel Clean. And you will get all the M-Channel Clean content at the same place. Let's start with the first clip. The shot is nice, but too static. Let's add a nice background animation to get more dynamism for this footage. I would like to use the background preset number 5. So let's add an adjustment clip, change the duration and place it over my clip. Now I will add the background preset to the adjustment clip. I can play it and see the animation. I will need to customize the effect. To do so, I will open the inspector. By default, we are on the video tab. Let's switch to the FX tab. Here we will find all the controls for our animation preset. First, you've got two checkboxes for the in and out animations. You can uncheck them to remove the animation and get directly the final effect. In this case, I want those animations, so I will keep them. Below, you will find content controls where you will be able to customize the look of the effect. For example, here, I will set the frame blur to 0. I will adjust the frame size using the slider or directly by tapping the right value. Next, I will get back the color by setting the saturation parameter to 0. And to conclude with this effect, I will add some brightness to the background. To complete this shot, I will add a title. I will use the preset number 1. I will drag it into the timeline and adjust the duration. First, I would like to keep the title until the end of the clip, so I will disable the animation out. Below, we have various controls for all the components which compose the title. With the text controls, I will modify the main text. I will type Fashion Experts. As I don't need subtitles, I will remove them. Inside the elements controls, I will be able to modify the graphics component, like the line and the black box. I don't want the black box, so I will set the alpha to 0. Perfect, let's have a look to the final result. Next, I will need to work on the transition with the second shot. As the models walk towards the camera, a crash zoom effect can match very well with the second shot. I will use the transition number 1. This one creates a nice crash zoom effect. Perfect. Let's add a new title over the second shot. I want that the title will start at the end of the first shot. I will use the lower third title preset number 2. I will adjust the end of the title on the composition of the three vertical shots. With the content controls, I will adjust the position and the scale. I will modify the header text by typing latest trends, and I will also modify the main title. And like the previous title, I will remove the black bar. Now we will work on the transitions of the three vertical clips. I will use the same preset, the number 1, on the three clips. Good. Next, I will use a preset number 3. It will add a unique animation to switch back to one horizontal shot. It is maybe too fast. Let's increase the duration to get a smoother result. In the inspector, I will add 6 frames. Perfect. For the next shot, no transitions, just a cut. But I will add a title. I will select the preset number 2. I've got a small problem as the text is over the eye of the model. So inside the content controls, I will adjust the Y position, like this. I will modify the main text and the header text. I don't need the 3 footer text, so let's remove them. In the element controls, I will remove the white rectangle. So if I set the alpha channel to 0, the rectangle is still there. You will have also to set the color to black to get it fully transparent. To add more dynamism between all these shots, I will add a nice letterbox overlay effect. So I will add an adjustment clip and set the in and out point. I will go to the overlay effects and drag the letterbox overlay on the adjustment clip. By default, the in and out animation are disabled, so I will activate them. This overlay adds some cinematic effect and at the same time unify all the various clips. Next, we will work on the last clip. To conclude the opener, I would like to add the logo of the channel. M-Channel Clean provides many titles where you can import logo or picture with drop zones. I will use the intro preset number 1, so I need first to add an adjustment clip and drag my intro on it. With this preset, you have the choice to use a logo, or if you don't have one, to switch to the text mode. In this case, I would like to use the logo mode. So inside the logo controls, I will import a logo by clicking on the browse button. This is a simple PNG file with the alpha channel. I will reduce the size a little bit. I don't need the subtitles, so I will remove them. And also, I want to keep the logo. I don't want the frame elements. So inside the frame controls, I reduce the thickness of the rectangle to 0. The cool thing is that you can mix multiple effects on the same adjustment clip. So for example, I can add a letterbox overlay effect on it. To conclude with this opener, I would like to add a texture effect over all the clips. Let's add a new adjustment clip. I will set the duration to cover all the lengths of the opener, and I will add an overlay texture effect on it. It works great, the only problem is that the effect is over all the elements, even the letterbox effect. To resolve this, I should modify the order of the effect. So you can do it manually and move one by one the effects, or you can do it quickly. Here's the tip. Place the cursor over the name of the track, do a right click. In the pop-up menu, you have the options to move the video track down. So I will do it 3 times to get my texture effects under the letterbox effect. On the last clip, I will have to move the adjustment clip over the texture effects, and we are good. M-Channel Clean is a powerful pack which will provide you elegant and sophisticated titles, transitions and effects for your channel. Easy to use and infinite possibilities for customizations. To get more information about M-Channel Clean and all the other plugins available for DaVinci Resolve, one address, motionvfx.com. Thanks for watching. Ciao ciao. Bye bye.